Hello everyone, I'm Rick Martin, Director of Communications and Community Relations for Douglas County. Joining me now is Dr. Janet Meemark of Cobb and Douglas Public Health. We're here because we've got a serious matter to talk about. COVID cases in Douglas County are rising. Is that correct, Dr. Meemark?
Yeah, that's where we're at right now, Rick.
What are the current COVID numbers and what trends are you seeing in Douglas County?
Yeah, so right now the case numbers for the PCR testing, which is the gold standard testing, is 4,430 cases. And right now we're at 197 cases per 100,000. So reminder to everybody once again, anything over 100 is considered to be high transmission. These case numbers, though, do not include the antigen test, which is the new test that's been really gaining a lot of popularity. So this is the point of care test that you get the result within 15 to 30 minutes. Now, the false negative rate is a little bit higher with that test. It's not as sensitive as the PCR test that we do in our drive-thrus in some of the doctor's offices. But when you get a positive, it is a positive. And so those numbers are contributing to these numbers as well. So we think that it's actually a little bit higher than the 197 that we see right now if you were to add those numbers in.
So nationally, we are seeing a large resurgence. What does this mean for Douglas County?
Yeah, so, you know, it was one of those things where we were just kind of waiting with bated breath on this. So we are seeing very, very significant surges throughout the nation, and especially in the Midwest and in the central plains area. But you might have heard just, I think, is this week and last week, Texas and California went over a million cases. And we had over 150,000 cases in the U.S. recently. So we were just on a kind of a unimpeded surge. So it has taken a little while for the Georgia metro area and parts of Georgia to be feeling this as well. So we are seeing an increase in our cases in the metro. And then we are starting to see hospitalization rates as well go up. And so even in a neighboring Cobb County, there has been an increase in hospitalizations due to COVID-19.
You know, experts, including you, have warned that infections could get worse with colder weather. Yeah. What should people do to prepare?
So, you know, you've heard about the vaccines that are coming, but this is a very, very initial stage. So we've got months to go before that vaccine comes out, right? So it's the same things that we have been talking about. And I think that we've just gotten a little lax on it. So, you know, it is the gotta wear your mask when you're out in public, especially as transmission rates go higher and higher. There's really very few ways to protect yourself. So wear the mask, keeping that distance, washing your hands. And we had talked about avoiding crowds, but what the CDC is seeing and what we're seeing is that transmission is happening in smaller groups. It doesn't have to be large groups. So, you know, people that are outside of your immediate family, that families getting together, friends to get together in smaller groups where you let your guard down, that's where we're actually seeing some very effective transmission.
Okay, that's really important, especially as we are approaching the holidays, as people are likely to gather for the holidays over the next few months. What should people remember to mitigate the spread of COVID-19?
Yeah, so I read today on the news that today's the day one of quarantine before your family comes in. So it's an important day to mark, right? So what does that mean? Well, these pseudo quarantines where you limit your contact with other people as much as you can and decrease your risk. So make sure you're really good about mask wearing, about keeping your distance and not having these little gatherings. So it's birthday parties and sleepovers and, you know, church gatherings, weddings. These are things that are contributing to the spread. Even at work, if you are working with people and not wearing masks, very effective ways to transmit. This is the time to just hunker down a little bit so that you can enjoy your time with your family, making sure that you are not sick when your family comes, or if your family is sick, that's very clear that we're gonna, you know, stay away if we are sick. And then doing some of those other things that we had talked about, you know, trying to be outdoors as much as you can. And the CDC has some great stuff about how to even prepare meals and serve and things like that. So this is a time right now to be thinking about how you're going to handle your holidays.
Gotcha. I'm hearing that we could have a vaccine before the end of 2020. Will it be rolling out in phases? What can you tell us about this?
Yeah, so we had some good news from the Pfizer company on their vaccine. So they're showing some over 90% effectiveness of the vaccine. So that's very good news. Now, the only thing, the problem with that is it's not going to be a whole lot of vaccine at first, right? So we have the priority list of the highest risk people that have to be vaccinated first. Those include your healthcare workers. So as hospital rates go up right now and our hospitals fill up, we definitely don't want to be losing our healthcare workers to COVID-19. So, and then we also have long-term care facility residents and staff members that also need to get the vaccine. And then we have our frontline safety members that are also in that group. And so what will happen is it will roll out slowly at first. The first vaccines, whatever they give us, we will treat as vaccinate as many people as we can. And then it should start rolling much quicker after that. They anticipate March, April, that most people will be able to have access to the vaccine at that time.
Wow. Is there anything else you'd like to tell the residents of Douglas County today?
Yeah, so we are, you know, I know I've told you this before, but, you know, we are at a really, really important juncture at this point. We have hospitals that are full, even our Douglas County Hospital. There are no ICU beds available right now, and they have low medical surgical beds. And so we have a vaccine. You can see the light at the end of the tunnel. We have to just push just a little bit longer. And I know it's been so hard for everybody, but we got to do what we know works. You got to wear those masks. You got to, you know, wash your hands and keep your distance. And, you know, don't let your guard down around. I know, you know, it's friends and family, but don't let your guard down at this time. I mean, just to tell you how effective the masks are, you know, we are not having a lot of transmission within classrooms because they're all wearing masks. What we're seeing, though, is they're bringing it in from outside the classrooms. And so whatever's happening in the community, so parties and gatherings and socializing, they're getting it outside, they're bringing it in, but transmission stops within because everybody's wearing masks and trying to be as far apart as possible. That's a great lesson for us. You know, we just got to keep pushing just a little bit longer until we can get this wiped out and then kind of move on with our lives.
So we just have to stay guarded.
Yeah.
Hunker down.
Hunker down.
Stay focused, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Gotcha. Dr. Meemark, thank you so much for joining us with this update. Look forward to speaking with you again soon.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.